Hi, this is Sid from Sitsin and with another knife review, and today we're doing the full review of the Little Bro Jack by Jack Wolf Knives. If you haven't seen already, please check out my unboxing. It will be linked here in the top right corner where I cover some of the specs and some of the different versions that were available and a bit of the backstory why this knife got delayed over 1.5 years. And we will not go over that in this video. This is going to be the kind of full review you'll like to see here on the channel, with all the specs and all my experience from actually carrying and using this knife. This came out or was available at the 17th of November of 2023 and came out in some gorgeous different versions. We will just go over them briefly here because some of them might still be available at the authorized dealers of Jack Wolf Knives. One of them is a highly recommended one by me. It's White Mountain Knives. You can use the discount code on other knives. I think on the Jack Wolf Knives, the discount code does not apply. And the different versions that were available were, of course, the one I have, which is the one that was also available on the original drop that happened over 1.5 years prior to the actual release now, and that is the Dark Matter Copper by Fat Carbon as the cover material here. Then there was a rosewood handled version that was first introduced by Jack Wolf Knives on their second release of the Swayback Jack, which is their laid back Jack model. And then there was a Flow Party camo carbon fiber that glows under UV light that lots of people really liked. And then there was also a Nebula Fat Carbon, which was also available on the Big Brother, which is the Big Bro Jack that we have here in a different kind of camo carbon. I think this is called Gecko camo carbon. And then the kind of most unique release in terms of cover materials was the Crystal Lake Kirunite, a gorgeous, very three-dimensional looking, highly polished Kirunite polymer cover that looked absolutely awesome. And these were the five different models that were available. All of them are price-wise the same as they have always been ever since they changed over to carbon fiber or kind of more high-end handle covers. So it's $299 on all the different models. Before, we had a little bit of less expensive option with the micardas, which are not available at this point. In terms of the artwork, we have the artwork by Sean Tiffany. So this is also the designer that started out with, or the artist that started out with Jack Wolf Knives in the beginning. And because this is an old release, we have the Sean Tiffany artwork and not the Jay Gonzo, which have been released on some of the re-releases that we have seen. For example, the Vampire Jack and the Laidback Jack. If you like my content, please don't forget to subscribe to me here on YouTube as well as on Instagram under 730_knife_reviews. And now let's get into the review of this absolutely gorgeous Jack Wolf Knife release. If you haven't heard of Jack Wolf Knives, check out some of my reviews. They are a newer company that kind of reinterpreted the modern, the traditional American folding knife or slip joint folder, and implemented some modern machining, modern materials, and just overall modern manufacturing into it, and kind of started a new kind of hype for these absolutely gorgeous patterns that they have released. And they have a lot of different models. I think with this year and the re-releases, we're looking at 17 different knives from Jack Wolf Knives at this moment. Most of them have been sold out, but there will be new re-releases coming from the knives we have already seen, and there will also be new knives, of course, in the coming month and years, and they run on a monthly release schedule, and this was the release for the month of November of 2023. So let's check out the specs here on this absolutely gorgeous clip point bladed sleeve board pattern, or boys knife pattern, slip joint by Jack Wolf Knives. That is called the Little Bro Jack. So we got an overall length of 6.38 inches or 15.7 centimeters with a blade length of 2.67 inches or 6.5 centimeters with a cutting edge that's slightly shorter at 2.37 inches or just at 6 centimeters. We got a blade stock of 3 millimeters of S90V steel at a Rockwell hardness of 60 to 61. We have the signature full height hollow ground blade absolutely nice and slicey, super sharp out of the box, and just absolutely gorgeously executed in this machine satin finish. You got the gorgeous clip point switch here at the front, a nice delicate and very pokey tip here in front, as I like to have it on my kind of secondary slip joint carry for some nice detailed work. This works absolutely fantastic. And then we're looking at a hand length of 3.54 inches or 8.9 centimeters. Weight wise, we are very lightweight here at 60 grams or 2.1 ounces. And price wise, as I said before, all of the five versions we mentioned before are running you $299, and they are available at the authorized retailers of Jack Wolf Knives. For more information and some pictures of all the different models, check out jackwolfknives.com. You see the website here on the sticker. All of the things you see here on the table are actually provided in the box or the tube that you're getting with the Little Bro Jack. There's also a large branded microfiber cloth. You get the slip, which is an essential feature, and the thing that I absolutely love about these Jack Wolf knives, that you get this very nice kind of slip right there. You get the pog that also features the artwork here on the back. So a really cool full package that you're getting from Jack Wolf Knives. Because this is the Little Bro Jack, there has to be a Big Bro. And let's jump into some size comparisons right away so you can see how these two knives stack up against each other. And you can certainly see that the Little Bro Jack is a bit smaller. We're looking at about a 10 to 15% size difference, but in hand and in use, this makes a big, big difference. I absolutely love the Big Bro when it came out, and it's also not too large. All of the knives that they have feature fit in this provided leather slip, but now that I have the Little Bro Jack, I absolutely love how it actually works and carries, and just is quite a bit different in the actual use case, and just the way I use slip joints, it really makes a difference having the Little Bro or the Big Bro Jack. They are similar, they are practically the same design, just size down, but it makes a lot of sense, and for me, this is the perfect size for a slip joint the way I use it. I usually carry another modern folder as well as my little slip joint by Jack Wolf Knives. Of course, I carried all of them that I have reviewed on the channel, but ever since I put the Little Bro here in my pocket with this gorgeous blade, absolutely amazing fit and finish that we are so used to now from Jack Wolf Knives, with the perfect fitting of all the materials, especially the back spring in all the different positions here. This just showed me that this is a size, a blade shape, and just an overall pattern that absolutely works for me. And this is probably one of my absolute favorite knives by Jack Wolf Knives. And just the size difference, even if it's not massive, really makes a difference in how it handles, how it performs, how you use it. This really surprised me how big of a difference there actually is, and it's absolutely easy to justify having both, even though they're practically the same design, but there is certainly enough difference to really notice when you're actually using and carry these knives. So ergonomically between the two models, still full forefinger grip in a hammer grip, in a saber grip, no issues whatsoever with my 7.5 sterile glove hand. Really, really nicely done, super symmetrical, gorgeous one fluted end cap and bolster. And if you compare it to the Big Bro Jack, same thing here. If you take a look at some other slip joint knives of the collection, which is mostly a Jack Wolf at this point, but I recently got another one here just to check my bias towards Jack Wolf Knives. And you can see here we have the Bottle Buster Junior by Esnix, built by Riot. And you can see size-wise, very, very similar. Here we have more of a saltbuster pattern, but you can see size-wise, very, very similar in terms of thickness in the handle. Also very, very similar here. So I think that's a good size comparison if you have handled or seen one of these Bottle Busters or Beer Busters. You certainly can see size wise very close to the Little Bro Jack, but in terms of action and just the overall experience, this kind of falls short in my opinion. Still a great knife, of course. We got also the gorgeous Damascus pattern, but When you compare it to something like this, it just can't stack up in my opinion. One of my all-time favorites from Jack Both Knives, here we have the Sharpshooter Jack first ever release. Gunstock pattern here by Jack Wolf Knives, and you can see this is certainly quite a bit larger in terms of overall size. And then another clip point blade, the Javelina Jack, absolutely gorgeous here with only one bolster, for example. Here we can see size wise this is also certainly larger. It's probably one of the kind of more traditional handle shapes or just overall blade profiles that we have here on the boy's knife or sleeve board pattern Little Bro Jack. But I think that certainly is one of its benefits. It's just so universal. It works for pretty much anything. It's very maneuverable, very versatile, and just an absolutely gorgeous and super balanced overall design that looks great and just works in pretty much every aspect that you would use a slip joint for. As you have seen before, Walk and Talk is just super crisp, not super overly strong. It's very nicely dialed in for the size of the knife, so it's easy to deploy and put back while still having this super crisp action and the great sound it produces. Perfectly centered. Just the quality here is outstanding and certainly stacks up to the price tag. And we also have a good sharpening choil. Sharpness out of the box is just impeccable as always. All the grinds are very classy, very clean and crisp, I wanted to say. And the only thing some people didn't really like is that because of the clean and crisp grinds and everything on the knife, the kind of edges here are not kind of broken. There is no chamfer right here. They're not sharp, you cannot cut yourself with it, but they can be a bit rougher for some people, and maybe that also varies a bit from model to model. But for me, I have no issues with the blade spine here. It's not too sharp or too kind of angular for me. And just overall, this knife is absolutely gorgeous, and as it stands right now, certainly one of my top 5 Jack Wolf knives here with the Little Bro Jack. I absolutely love the Big Bro, but the Little Bro is, in my experience or in my opinion, even better, just the way I use my slip joint. So absolutely great release here by Jack Wolf Knives, and these are available since the 17th of November. If you can find one, I highly recommend to get one. This can be your only slip joint folder that you will carry every day together with a modern folder or just on its own, and you will not be disappointed. The S90V steel holds up great. The grind is perfect for a slip joint, super thin, super slicey, and it just does absolutely everything you want it to do while looking super, super stunning and being just an absolute work of art by Jack Wolf Knives. And I really like the company, but this is just an amazing release and certainly one of the best they have ever done, and it was so worth the wait with all the kind of troubles they had in the beginning with the Little Bro Jack. And I'm super happy that it finally came out, and certainly congrats to Ben Belkin for pulling this off once again. If you liked the video, please click the like button, subscribe to me here on YouTube as well as on Instagram at 7ready_knife_reviews. Check out all the links in the description below. Thank you for watching, have a nice day, and goodbye.